watch myself.
I take their option for Smashville, which is interesting since I know both of these players like Town and City. So I would have assumed they would have just struck there immediately.
Moog's one of those guys who, he really performs his best in doubles and shines like a god in doubles, quite honestly.
Yes.
In singles, he doesn't really have the same results to match, but he's still not one of those people that you could ever... Ooh!
Okay, yeah, he still had his double jump. He's still living.
That you could ever really count out.
Oh, good spacing on that back air, jumping over the egg.
Yeah. Oh, he ends up not snapping to the ledge right there.
Ooh.
Maybe he was pressing down for just a second too long. Who knows?
Oh, that... I am always surprised when players decide, you know what, I should land on Ike.
Yeah.
Especially when he's charging an up smash. That's such a terrifying decision, and like at best you're just going to get air dodge lag next to them, so you're just going to be on even frame data.
Yeah. So it's right back to it. Probean still making great work with his double jump. His double jump game is really strong. You have to be able to bait people out and then have the availability of throwing out another aerial with that double jump.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's why we see from both Stark and Probeans them being able to take out some really high caliber players, because it's all about the mind game. It's like, oh, I'm right here, hit me. And then it's like, oh no. Next thing you know, you end up getting Aethered.
And the nice thing about it is, thanks to like the sword hitbox, you can feel, the opponent can feel threatened by you without you actually putting yourself at risk or committing to anything. You just, you know, hover in the space below them. You just keep doing that until you get a read on what their habit is, and then you can actually punish them for it.
Oh,
good confirm off the forward air.
Chases him to the heavens right there.
I feel like all the players now have learned perfect pivoting exclusively for the stock change dance.
Yeah.
Like, I have never seen any of these players use it in the neutral.
Yeah. I've seen Trayvante use it once on a combo. One time.
Yeah. And you see a lot of Trayvante.
And that was it. I was like, oh, cool. He's about to do the void. Oh, he dropped it. And then it went on. I was like, cool. Yeah. Not too much perfect pivoting going on. I really think that unless your dash is amazing, perfect pivoting has its place here and there, but it's really for extending combos.
Mm. And like maybe extending punish range for like a smash attack or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh
that's going to be some nice 30%.
You can tell when somebody really enjoys the stage, and Moog is showing that right now. Yoshi with good aerial mobility can make these platforms their playground.
It's also just the fact that he's able to cover those platforms above him, right? He can reach all of them with up smash, if I remember correctly, yeah.
It's very easy to toss an aerial through those as well.
Yeah, you see Probeans was expecting that. He came down with a counter.
Moog in a tough spot here on the ledge. I feel like a lot of people don't know how to handle the ledge.
Yeah.
Seems like a very common thing.
Like, a lot of people just kind of find their one niche option that, like, it's hard to adapt to within, like, a short two-stock set.
Yeah.
They just, like, keep doing that and hope the opponent doesn't figure out what the right answer is.
Yeah. Probean's been taking little chunks of damage here and there.
Oh, what a good forward smash.
So well spaced. That move is so hard to punish, too.
Because like his whole head is also like invincible and like disjointed as well, so
it
makes it a good spacing tool. Yeah.
So you're like, oh man, I'm gonna catch him with this. And you're just like, no, goodbye.
Yeah. Yoshi like is that character who's a walking frame trap.
Yeah.
Everything he does doesn't have as much lag as you feel like it should.
Since he's so heavy as well, and the last two hits from Probeans definitely would have killed most other characters.
Yeah.
Yoshi is still living.
Oh, misses the punish off the spot dodge. Moog, barely mistimes that F smash, but Probean still has trouble finding a kill at this percent.
He is sliding off of these platforms and getting to the ground so swiftly. And Probean's is having a hard time getting back himself. It's been a big difference between the two of them.
Wow, what a great landing option. I love it when characters know to land with their command grab sometimes.
Yeah. Also using them to B reverse in the air.
Yeah.
All of a sudden move themselves. What a grab.
What amazing placement and good punish on the down air.
Those platforms. Moog, that's his stage.
Yeah.
That is his stage.
Oh, winner is
I mean, I feel like when you're a character where like everyone says, oh, your best stage is like town and city or something, it's now on you as a player to figure out what your actual favorite stage is, because no one's ever gonna let you have it. Like a Pikachu will never get Lilat, so a Pikachu needs to learn what his favorite stage is.
You gotta get out of those situations.
Last time I fought Probeans, I remember he counterpicked to town and city, but I don't feel like that's a good move against Yoshi.
Yeah.
So yeah, Final Destination is similar enough. A bit of a risky pick for Ike, though. I feel like Ike, as a character, really likes platforms. It allows him to mix up his recovery, for example, between like all the different platform hypes or the ledge. Now he has the choice of being above the stage, where Yoshi can reach him quickly with his fast like airspeed, or snapping ledge predictably. But if he gets in first, he should be able to just carry on that momentum with that big sword so that Yoshi never gets to land ever.
Yeah, I feel like both of these characters are going to have that problem. Yoshi can try and, you know, mix up the timings with eggs or trying to be reverse man grab, but Probeans is really good at catching people for their landing habits.
Mm-hmm. Oh, good jab to cover that option.
Moog is looking fierce right now.
Moog really wants this.
I mean, when you're in your hometown, defending the crown.
This is actually a very even stock right now.
Yeah. Both of them understand that, like, if they were to make a mistake while throwing out these moves, like, they're just trying to do, like out of shield there. Very, very safe thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
Probeans is not going in for heavy committed moves. He's trying to get some grabs, it's definitely going to be helping him out, but
Moog keeps calling exactly where Probeans ends up at the end of those.
Yeah. Probeans kind of faded back, looked like he was going to the ledge, and then just lets rip a side B.
I mean, that's the thing, it's now a 50-50 thanks to the nature of FD.
Yeah. Like you said, those platforms could have helped out quite a bit, but nice up tilt right there. Another issue in this matchup, though, on this stage is that...
Oh, good back air.
Getting those kills
so
is
heavy.
A lot harder. This stage doesn't have the same dimensions as a lot of the other stages, which are mostly smaller. So he's kind of putting himself at a slight disadvantage.
Oh, wow. That's really good to know that Ike's up tilt outranges the command grab. Oh, okay.
Definitely making it back. Get some solid damage out of it as well. One good combo and Probeans is caught up percent-wise.
Like, Probeans is trying to weave in and out of Moog's range because he doesn't want to stay there too long because of Moog's frame data. But the problem is every time he goes for the weave out, Moog can just throw an egg after him, and now he's in an advantage state.
Moog has been landing these dash attacks and getting Probeans into the air and forcing Probeans to use his second jump to get away every single time.
Mm-hmm.
Since getting high, Yoshi has no problems killing when it connects. Percent is not too much of an issue.
Oh, that's still gonna live great DI.
Yeah. Probeans snaps to the ledge. He can't afford not to.
Yeah.
Still has his jump, but this is a tough situation.
Great pick off by Moog.
Yep.
Wow.
Taking it 2-1. Moog looking like a completely different beast in singles now.
Wow. Didn't he just beat Solimar